It's 4 p.m., you're still 2 or 3 hours away from dinner, and all you can think about is that big bag of potato chips or maybe some chocolate chip cookies. We all get cravings, and usually they aren't for the healthiest things. Today, our guest is Joanne Rechten, wellness coordinator with Owen J. Roberts School District and a freelance food writer.
Hi, Beth.
And cooking instructor. Joanne, thanks so much for being with
us.
Nice
to be here.
We all get cravings. There's no two ways about it. Doesn't matter who you are. We all get them. But there are some things that we can do to outsmart them.
Right.
And that's what we're going to talk about today is how do you outsmart your cravings?
It is good to have some strategies in place when you're going to get those cravings. And also, it's really important to understand why we're getting the cravings.
Okay, let's start with that. Let's go through some of the basic reasons. First of all, one common reason I think a lot of people end up with cravings is they're stressed. So that's maybe a question you should ask yourself.
Right.
Am I stressed?
Am I feeling stressed or under pressure? Because when we're stressed, our bodies actually produce a hormone called cortisol. And cortisol actually leads our brain to seek rewards. So it's actually biological that we're seeking. A lot of times we put food as the reward, and we seek especially fatty foods, starchy, sugary foods, because it shuts down the cortisol production.
So what do we do to fix that?
First of all, I think it's important to have some substitutions
okay.
in mind when we're looking for calming ourselves down.
Right.
So
healthier things that you can do.
That's right.
And what would be some examples of that?
Well, right away, if we are craving like chips, we may want to substitute for popcorn.
Okay. All right. How about things like some people say getting outside and taking a walk or something like that?
Right. Once again, it's good to realize ask yourself, why am I stressed? Because if you're lonely and go out for a walk, you might just be doing more harm than good. So exercise often is a good way to reduce stress, but sometimes we might need to talk to a friend.
So listen to some music, go online, do something, whatever it is that makes you.
Right.
Some of the things that we typically eat when we're stressed, we have some examples. A lot of people go for the crunch when they're stressed.
The salt and the crunch.
Yeah, so we have some typical snack foods here.
Pretzels, chips, Cheetos, Doritos. And we kind of teach our brain to associate certain foods. So if we, say, have a fight with somebody and get stressed out about that and have Cheetos, the next time when we're experiencing that emotion, we may just grab the Cheetos before we even think about it because we've kind of taught our brain that association.
Interesting. And another common craving trigger is when we're not actually eating enough.
That's true. Serious dieting, when we're eliminating food categories like carbs, we're eating under 1,000 calories a day, crash dieting. Actually, biologically, there are hormonal change that lead us to really have strong cravings that are really hard to beat.
And some of the things that we might want to reach for at those times?
Yeah, your comfort foods, those chocolate chip cookies, the cinnamon buns, they really help us feel calm, but it only lasts an instant.
Right. So so the solution to that, don't ban any food. If you want ice cream, maybe have a smaller cone, for example.
Exactly.
Okay.
You can cut a lot of calories just by allowing yourself the food and just cutting the portion, really limiting your portions.
Also, you say don't eat around your cravings. And I know I have done this myself, that I know that I want a cookie. And so instead I have some crackers, and then later I have, maybe a piece of fruit or something. And if I had just had the cookie to begin with, I would have eaten fewer calories.
You can really pile on the calories if you try to just outsmart your craving. Sometimes you can substitute something that's similar enough, and we'll probably talk about some of that. But
And we have some examples, for instance,
instead
of a milkshake.
So you're craving a milkshake. You may be able to have yogurt.
Some chocolate milk.
Or some chocolate milk. Some chocolate soy milk and still kind of get around those cravings.
Or how about a smaller cone instead of the big cone? Even just a small portion of it sometimes is enough
to
satisfy.
Denying ourselves usually doesn't work in the long run.
Another somewhat surprising reason for cravings is a lack of sleep.
It's true. Research shows that even a few nights of sleep deprivation can whack your hormones out so that you have the inability to feel full. And you're hungry more often.
Sometimes we also have cravings just because it's a habit. You know, we sit down in front of the TV, for instance, and
we want that bowl of popcorn. Right. It's so easy. We're so smart, and our brain loves routine. So a lot of times, if, you know, we can create habits just innocuously by, you know, sitting in front of the TV with food. Next time you sit in front of the TV, you want the same food.
You say portion control is a good way to beat that.
Right.
We have some portion controlled 100-calorie packs of things, and the smaller bags of popcorn.
Our food manufacturers have come a long way to help us out with some of that. But even if we have a large bag and we want chips, portion out, find out what a serving is on the back of the bag and give yourself that serving in a bowl.
Great.
And sit down. Another strategy is not to sit so close to the kitchen when you're watching TV.
That's a great idea.
Kitchen if you're away from the food.
That's a great idea. You have some ideas for some simple substitutions too that will actually save us a lot of calories but may still satisfy that craving. So instead of one regular candy bar, you suggest
85% dark cocoa. You know, the high cocoa content is really, it's proven to be heart healthy. So it's a great option, and you still get that nice, rich chocolate flavor without going overboard with the calories.
Or the chocolate soy milk.
That's a good try.
We have
only you will know whether that's going to do it or not.
And you have to
figure that out.
Microwave popcorn, small bags of chips, and here's an example. Instead of a whole scoop of chocolate chip cookie dough, have a small cone.
Right. You can cut 300 calories or so just by making a choice like that. And especially if you go with a frozen yogurt. A lot of times I even choose like a granita, which is kind of just a frozen juice. You can cut all those calories and I still get the nice slushy flavor that I'm looking for.
Another idea that a lot of people don't think about but you say works well is at the end of the night when you're done eating, most of us wait to brush our teeth before we go to bed, but
that's a strategy. Brushing your teeth actually just kind of puts a change in your desires. Chewing gum can do the same thing.
That's great. Pop a mint.
Yeah, pop a mint. Also, just wait it out. We all think the craving is going to overwhelm us, but if we just wait it out, cravings actually are like waves, and they kind of build and crest, and then they subside.
That's great. Joanne, thanks so much for all your tips. Everyone gets cravings, but there's some simple things you can do to try to outsmart them. First of all, think about why you have the craving. Is it just because you see the food there? Are you really hungry? Or are you maybe just stressed? Try some alternatives like taking a walk, having a cup of tea, brushing your teeth, or having a mint. And think about some simple substitutions that might satisfy the craving but save you some calories. For more information, visit our website.